Evening. Going to ask everybody tonight to unplug your cell phones. So not just silence them. They're going to be off. There's going to be great pictures and videos. So we're just going to say no videos or pictures going on during the ceremony. Are you ready for a great evening? Here we go.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Won't you stand by me? Stand by me. That we look upon, oh, should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea. Oh, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Won't you stand by me? Stand by me. Won't you stand by me? When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Won't you stand by me? Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon. Oh, should tumble and fall. Or the mountain should crumble to the sea.
Gathered here together today in the sight of God, in the presence of friends and family, to celebrate the union of Jack Schlemmy and Hannah Randolph in holy matrimony. So who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Brother and I do.
Go ahead, Jack. You all may be seated. Beautiful. How we doing?
Good.
Breathing. Good. Breathing. There we go. No, it's good. Listen, marriage, as you both know, It's the most sacred of any relationship we have, and it should be entered into reverently, with much thought, full understanding of its sacred nature, a full reliance on the love that you have for one another and the power of the faith that you have for one another. So this is a special day, obviously, but it's special for me too because I am Hannah's uncle. This is my niece right here. And so when Hannah and Jack asked if I would officiate the ceremony and do pre-marriage counseling, I said, absolutely. Absolutely. I wanted to help them get a good start, learn some tools, see that they succeed. And there was another reason too. I needed to make sure you were legit. I didn't know him. And really, to be honest here, no kidding, it wasn't even just for me or Hannah. It was for that big guy right there on the front row, her dad. He's always watching, Jack. Jack, always. Now, Jack is legit. This has been such an honor. I have watched how you have cared for Hannah and put her needs above your own. I have watched how you have honored him and respected him. And I celebrate this day as two young, really uniquely beautiful people come together in holy matrimony. So it's cold, I'm not going to be long, but I want to give you just an encouragement, and it's going to center around love. I'm going to use love as an acronym. And so L would begin with laughter. These are four things that I want you to remember to incorporate into your marriage. Laughter. You both have similar uniquenesses, characteristics. You do. You have a strong love for your family. You have a strong love for God. You carry very similar principles and convictions that you're going to build on. And yet, you guys are as polar opposite as the day is long as well. Jack is very pragmatic and has a very logical approach to life, which is his strength. That's a gift for him. He is going to draw lines very much like this in order to bring success in their life. And Hannah is going to break every one of those lines and color outside of them. The key is to do what you're doing right now, to laugh at each other and with each other. Laughter is great medicine for the soul. So that's the first one. O is opportunity. Today's not the first day you fell in love, but today is the beginning of the rest of your life. And you guys have this incredible opportunity to seize it. Two are better than one. To go through life together. That's an amazing thing. So hold on to that. And as you are, use V, which is value. This is an ingredient to a successful marriage, Jack and Hannah. And that's to place a great value on the other person. To understand this is a son of God and this is a daughter of God. And to look not only for that other person to be what you need them to be for you, but how can you place value on that other person? That's V, value. And the last one is engage. Engage. One of the things that I so value in marriage, even in my own marriage, is that we engage each other. We speak of the beautiful things, and we speak into the ugly things. We want to engage each other in the mountains and in the valleys. Every season of life, do it together. There's going to be times where you're going to look at her, pardon me, you're going to wake up and look at her, and this precious, beautiful young lady, you're going to think, not so kind thoughts sometimes. It's going to happen. And Hannah, you're going to wake up in the morning, pull over, look at him and go, what the heck? You're going to have those. The best marriages do. So here's my parting advice on this subject. When you don't know what else to do, because there will come those times, you love one another. You make a choice to say, I'm in this. I want to read a passage of scripture that speaks to what love really is. 1 Corinthians 13, love is very patient and kind. It is never jealous or envious. It is never boastful or proud. Love is never haughty or selfish or rude. Love does not demand its own way. Love is not irritable or touchy. Love does not hold grudges and will hardly notice when others do it wrong. Love is never glad about the other's failures or injustice, but rejoices when truth wins out. If you love someone, you will be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You will always believe in them, always expect the best in them, and will always stand your ground in defending them. That's love. Love never fails. So you are holding hands while you are. We're at a part in the ceremony where I'm going to ask you to repeat these vows after me. So Jack, I'll ask you first. If you would, I, Jack, take you, Hannah.
I, Jack, take you, Hannah.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
The difficult and the easy.
The difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come, I will be there.
Whatever may come, I will be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Very good. And Hannah, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me as well. You can breathe. Yeah. Very good. You ready? Okay. I, Hannah, take you, Jack.
I, Hannah, take you, Jack.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh.
You're doing it. Good.
But he's not crying with me. I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
The difficult and the easy.
The difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come, I will be there.
Whatever may come, I will be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Very good. Jack, I'm going to ask you first, and if you're in agreement with this, you simply respond by saying, I do. That's good. So do you, Jack, take Hannah to be your wife?
I do.
I was not done. But that's good. That was the correct answer.
I wrote it back.
And do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others, holding only to her forevermore?
I do.
That was the correct answer. Hannah, do you, Hannah, take Jack to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others, holding only to him forevermore?
I do.
Very good. You're welcome. Who has the ring? Okay, thank you, John. Marriage is a covenant, and there are different forms of covenant. With a covenant comes the giving and receiving of a sign of that covenant. In the marriage ceremony, it's the ring, which speaks of an unbroken circle. It had a beginning, but there will be no end. And the precious metal that these rings are made of that speak to this unique love that you have for one another. And so as I give you these rings, Jack, I'm going to give you the ring for Hannah first. I want you to remember these rings as a symbol of the vows that you take, whether you are together or apart for whatever reason. You remember the vows through the giving and receiving of the rings. So go ahead and place that on her finger as you repeat this after me. I, Jack.
I, Jack.
Take you, Hannah.
Take you, Hannah.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Very good.
And Hannah, I'm going to ask you to place that on Jack's finger as you repeat after me. I, Hannah, take you, Jack.
I, Hannah, take you, Jack.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold. In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Very good. That is great. At this time, Jack's younger brother, Paul, is going to sing a beautiful song, Love Never Fails. And while he is singing this song, the parents of Jack and the parents of Hannah are going to come up and they're going to be praying for them. And during this time, Jack and Hannah also want to invite you, friends and family. There, when you came in, there was a card and a paper on your seat. And we welcome you to take that now and fill that out. Write down any thoughts and prayers that you may have for Jack and Hannah. And I'll let you know what to do with those following the ceremony. So go ahead and do that while the song is going on. Thank you.
Love is not proud. Love does not boast. Love after all matters the most. Love does not run. Love does not hide. Love does not keep locked inside. Love is the river that flows through, and love never fails you. Love will sustain, love will provide, love will not cease at the end of time. Love will protect, love always hopes, love still believes when you don't. Love is the arms that are holding you, and love never fails you.
Thank you, everyone, for writing down those thoughts and prayers. All right, now, we're going to take just a step back here Jack and Hannah, you guys come on here. A lot of times there's a unity candle in a marriage ceremony, which represent two lives becoming one. We never knew about the wind, and it's never a good sign when the wind blows out the candles. So we're going a little different here for this, and this is sand, which represents their individual lives. And when they come together as one, because the Bible says the two become one, they don't lose who they are individually. They just strengthen that bond in oneness. And so as a symbol of your two lives becoming one, I'm going to ask you to pour together into this jar here. Good. There's some that fell out, so there will be some hard years. I'm kidding. This represents two lives becoming one, and as you can tell, it would be very hard to remove them and separate them together. You two, I want you to keep this, and may it be a reminder of the vows that you've taken, of your I do's, of the rings that you have exchanged, and what you have done here today, which is a beautiful thing. So we're going to go ahead and come on and back out here. And I'm going to ask everybody, would you bow your heads and would you pray with me as we ask God's blessing upon this union. Father God, we thank you. We ask you that you would bless this marriage of Jack and Hannah as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead, all the turns, all the bends that are going to come. But help them to make the best of whatever comes their way, to love each other through it all, and to keep their eyes on you, God. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, their opinions and beliefs, their hopes and dreams and fears, even though they may not always understand the other. And God, I pray that you would help them, keep them in love, the love that they have for each other, and that the love that they share for you, we pray that you would always be prominent in their lives. And we give you thanks for it today, God. Bless them. In Jesus' name. Amen. So, by the power vested in me, by the state of California, more importantly, God's blessings, it's my great pleasure now to pronounce you husband and wife. Hold on. Now you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, my pleasure to present to you the happy couple, Mr. and Mrs. Jack and Hannah Shalemi. you, everybody. This is Jack and Hannah. I want to invite you to go up on the deck. It's cocktail hour. Some of the family has some pictures they're going to take real quick, and then they're going to join you up there. And also those cards that you have, there's a basket up there where you can put those down. So God bless you. Thank you for being here. Enjoy yourselves.